how does this work in terms of cultural roots? But I think that one of the strengths, but also the weaknesses of cultural roots, is that they are usually designed to link up physical culture. So you have very clear points along a route which are interspersed with these physical elements which people can visit. But that tends to limit the creativity of the route itself, because you have a particular theme, you have particular places that people visit, and you have a limited story that you tend to tell. So I think what our review of the cultural routes reveal is that the cultural routes themselves need to be increasingly creative. We've seen some good examples in the presentations in the previous session, but I think that there is a lot more room for creativity on the part of the cultural routes. And they need to think about how their creativity fits in to some of these local, national, global networks that we've been talking about. And we need to develop systems of co-creation. It's not just about the routes themselves developing things for local residents or visitors. It's about using those people to co-create their own experiences. So it's not just about using the creativity of the route, it's also about using the creativity of the visitor. And if we think about it in that way, as a co-created experience, we can start to develop much clearer links between tourism, culture, and creativity. And the bottom line for me is that creative tourism should be a means of rethinking place. It should be not just thinking about, well, what do we have from the past, what are we proud of, but how can we use that creatively in the present to develop new opportunities for cultural, economic, and social development. That's the important thing for me. And so I think there are opportunities for the cultural routes to develop new forms of cultural tourism which link to important themes such as those of the Council of Europe, for example, including things like human rights, democracy, social cohesion, intercultural dialogue, and all these kind of things. But if we're going to link to these kind of things in a creative way, then we need to be able to develop cultural routes in a way which is much more relevant to the target users as well as to these universal themes. And my argument would be that narrative provides the essential link between people, places, and creativity. And that, in many senses, is just as important as the physical heritage which these routes represent. I just want to give you an example of the power of narrative relative to physical heritage. And this is the city of Den Bosch. Den Bosch is the birthplace of Hieronymus Bosch, who was a very famous medieval painter. The problem that Den Bosch had is that it didn't have any of Bosch's paintings. Those paintings are spread around Europe in museums, in Madrid, in Lisbon, London, you name it. But Den Bosch has no paintings. So for years and years and years, they ignored their Bosch heritage because they didn't have any physical remains. Usually you start with the physical remains and develop a tourism product. In this case, they had no physical remains, so they had no product to develop, or so they thought. Until they decided, well, you know what? We're going to develop a story around Hieronymus Bosch, and we're going to use that story to move physical things. And so what they did was they created a series of events themed around the year of his death, the 500th anniversary of his death, which will be in 2016. And on the basis of this, they formed a network of Bosch cities, which includes Lisbon and Madrid and all the other places where the paintings are. And what they did was they did a very smart deal. They said, look, the Netherlands is very good at restoring paintings. So we will restore your Bosch paintings if you lend them to us for a couple of months in 2016. And the museum said, ah, that sounds like a good deal. And so what they got was an exhibition of Boss paintings, probably the biggest exhibition of Boss paintings ever mounted, without having to pay any money for the paintings apart from the cost of restoration, which was covered by sponsorship. And immediately, from a story about the connection of Boss with his birthplace, he created a physical movement of material heritage to a place which earlier had no physical heritage. And this system is a very interesting illustration of the creative compensation for a lack of physical heritage by developing creativity. So I think what we're essentially seeing is a movement from cultural roots old style, and Carlos will recognise this picture because this comes from the Crafts Roots, which we originally developed in the 1990s from the Eurotext project. You can see that this is in the pre-internet era because we only had telephone numbers for these craft producers. These days we would have websites. But this is the old style of putting a route together. You've got physical culture, you link it together by a route, and you send people along to consume the culture. That's the old style. Hopefully, this is what we're looking at in terms of the new style. We're seeing new routes emerging, such as the Rota de Romanico, Rota de Fresco, which are taking experiences as the basis of the cultural offer that they are giving to tourists. So this is creating a completely new concept of cultural routes based on creativity. And this, I think, is the way forward. So just to conclude, I think that cultural tourism is changing very, very rapidly from an old model based on purely on tangible heritage to a much wider and diverse system of consumption and production. It's moving from a classic system of sightseeing, being taken around in buses and photographing things, into being creative and being a creative being. And cultural roots have the potential to provide the narrative which can link creative spaces and can link places with the tourists who visit them. But that kind of linkage requires new ways of thinking and new tools. And I hope that as a result of this conference, we will be a lot further along the route to finding those new tools. Thank you very much.